Few people know that 300 kilometers off the west coast of Vancouver Island lies a chain of underwater volcanoes known as the Juan de Fuca Ridge. Part of this region was established as a marine protected area in 2003. This is where we find deep sea hydrothermal vents.
So hydrothermal vents are located at mid-ocean ridges. So picture it as seams along a baseball. And when you go away from these seams, it's almost like the desert. There's not really much life there. It's called the abyssal plain, so it just looks like mud flats going on and on and on. When you get closer to these little seams on the baseball, at the hydrothermal vents, you see an abundance of life. Hydrothermal vents form when two plates are separating away from each other and new crust from the Earth's center starts migrating upwards. You'll have water that percolates through this really super hot crust, and from pressure and both temperature, it'll come back up and start precipitating these minerals out once it reaches that cold seafloor. So you'll get these precipitations slowly start forming these hydrothermal chimneys. And once the temperatures as well as the right conditions are available for new animals, they'll start colonizing these hydrothermal vents.
So we can go from a volcanic eruption that essentially flattens everything to the beginnings of a vent ecosystem with a number of species within less than a year.
They're at depths usually between 1,500 meters to up to 4,000 meters below the sea surface. So basically no sun can penetrate these environments. It's in complete darkness. The ambient seawater is usually about 2 degrees at those depths, but at these hydrothermal vents, you're getting these, just like picture underwater volcanoes. They're spewing out these hot vent fluids that are up to 400 degrees Celsius in some cases. They're extremely toxic, so you have hydrogen sulfide, carbon dioxide, methane. So for you and I, there's no way we'd be able to survive at these hydrothermal vents.
Wow, pretty extreme conditions at these deep sea vents. How can anything actually live there?
You're on an underwater volcano where there's absolutely nothing alive, and then boom, you come across this little oasis of life with color, reds, blues, and animals you've never seen before. Everything we brought up had never been seen by a scientist before. Bottom few hundred meters of water contains millions of larvae of vent animals that have been released by vent ecosystems in the surrounding area. These larvae are constantly looking for, urgently looking for a new place to settle down. They detect the vent environment, they come in, settle down on the seafloor, and transform into juveniles and then adult animals. And they can colonize in a matter of months. Most of the animals that live there are unusually tolerant of high temperatures, toxic hydrogen sulfide, and even heavy metals. There's a really limited number of species that can colonize hydrothermal vents, but those that can really cut it do really well. We find incredible biomass in this environment, even though there are a very small number of species. Some of the more common animals at hydrothermal vents in the North Pacific are the giant tube worms. These are large worms that can be up to 2 meters in length. They have no mouth, no digestive system. The only way that they can exchange anything with the outside world is through their gills.
They survive by this symbiotic relationship with bacteria. And essentially what they do is they uptake this bacteria into an internal organ called the trophosome. And the trophosome houses all these bacteria. And if you have seen a picture of a tube worm, they have these red bushy plumes at the anterior portion of their body, and they uptake these dissolved gases, which are toxic to you and I. So it'd be hydrogen sulfide, carbon dioxide, as well as oxygen. And essentially this feeds the internal bacteria that provide the sole and only nutrition for the tube worms. Hydrothermal vents are a highly ephemeral environment, and by ephemeral I mean it's very dynamic. Vents are shutting off and then turning back on and starting up in a new location, or even vents can shut off and then turn back on again at the same location later on. So life itself at these vents that are turning off usually end up collapsing or dying, but then you'll see them pop up at these new hydrothermal vents and recolonize new areas. So it's very dynamic and it's constantly circling around. As they die out, they'll recolonize new vents again.
Today we had a chance to learn more about hydrothermal vents and the unique species that live there. Thanks to the team at Ocean Networks Canada, and thanks to you for being part of our ongoing explorations here at Ocean Alive.